Ultimakers have worked for us because they do exactly what they say they do right out of the box. So I'm Cameron Stern, creative director, co-founder and owner of Stern Design Works.
I'm Rebecca Stern, co-founder of Stern Design Works.
We work on STEM-infused jewelry, combining science, technology, math, and art with traditional metalsmithing and new techniques. We are in the fashion jewelry world. We'll put out about 500 pieces of jewelry a month, but then when it comes down to our big wholesale seasons and some of the major clients we have, it'll be 2,000 plus. Ever since I was a little kid, I was always really fascinated with 3D printers. When I saw that there was a way to bring the CAD work that I was doing into the 3D world, that's what got me hooked on 3D printing.
We wanted to make miniatures.
We actually have a line that's up to 150-ish figurines.
Cameron and I have always just loved that you can create giant worlds, but smaller.
In our business, we found lots of ways to fit our Ultimakers into our workflow. We're able to print in PLA and just go directly to our caster, but it only takes up from the bench that's 10 feet away from me to the printers right behind me. Adding in PVA support has been just the biggest boost to what we do with the 3D printed miniatures.
To get to that perfect piece, there are a lot of factors that can upset the balance.
When you deal with tiny things like the horns on top of a giraffe's head, and that giraffe is only 20 millimeters tall, you're gonna lose a bunch of those.
So with 3D printing, you can make one piece or 10 iterations of something, and you have 10 tries to get a perfect. Handling a 3D printed piece versus a wax piece, it's a quarter of the time.
And that time is much better spent painting models or getting orders ready to go out to our wholesalers. It's not just the time we've saved, it's what else we've been able to do with that time. That's been the biggest savings.
3D printing is a perfect mesh between that science and technology, engineering and math, but it's also that artistic aspect that we can throw into it.
It's nice when innovation has actually matched what we need to do in the studio and allowed us the tools to experiment.